setting it off is the legendary ultimate DJ Double K, the realness.
The realness. The realness.
What it was for you about to be the mix. Excuse me, by me, myself, the ultimate DJ, Double K, live on Storage Room Radio International, the realness, word up. Another edition, another archive, Tuesday's edition, I should say, where I, you know, I dig in my archives and I find my, what, you know, some of my classic tapes and I play it out there to, you know, all you out there in the audience that may not have heard this, you know, spanning my 38-year DJ career, you know, it's like, man, the archives is like real crazy. You dig what I'm saying? So it's like, you know, with the technology today, now we can present that, those archives from back in the days, you know, when you just making tapes in the bedroom and, you know, you was just stopping here and all of that, you know. So that's what I'm gonna do today. I was digging in my archives and I found one of my classic mixtape, bedroom mixtapes from 1985. Man, 15 years old, you dig what I'm saying? In the project bedroom, first floor, 445 Robinson Court apartment, 98 first floor, word up. 1985 practice tape, I dug in the archives and I couldn't believe it when my ass set sight on it, you know what I'm saying? Because like I said, I got mad tapes, but they like, I'm in the, I've got some organized, but now I'm getting ready to get to the next level of tapes, you dig what I'm saying? And, you know, it's like, to hear this tape brings tears to my ass. All of it always does, because I still feel like that 15-year-old kid in the bedroom. Ain't nothing changed. I never lost no enthusiasm. I never lost no passion. In fact, I gained more passion. And I can honestly say that I still got the same passion at almost 50 years old. So to me, that says a lot. So that's, you know, hey, man, history, it shuts everything down. It shuts lies down, first and foremost, hearsay down, and it put everything in a better perspective, and you can get a better perspective of me myself by just listening to it. You know what I'm saying? Because, like I always say, I'm not a YouTube DJ. I'm just utilizing this technology to put the history out there and give the realness back to the world the way I think it's supposed to be, or the way I came up hearing it. Word up. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? So it's a beautiful thing, man, you know, that to hold on to your history. And, you know, because like I said, I'm a real historian. So I don't believe in talking about what you did and all of that. I need you to show me or let me hear or show me some visual documentation of you doing what you said you did. You know what I'm saying? Because that's what I'm all about over here. So, yeah, man, you know what I'm saying? This is going to be like my first time hearing it. It's just a raw tape. So you're going to hear the hissing and the hussing and the throwing it in. I was mixing a little bit on it, but I think I was just practicing, because what I would do was every time I would get the money, we go buy the new jams and then we come make a tape right there and then with that new jam. So we ain't even really practicing, or I ain't practicing to just show no skill set. I'm just trying to hear the jam. And then when I hear a nice part, I'll hop on and do a little mix here and there just to break it in or whatever. And all real DJs know what I'm talking about when you hear that. You know what I'm saying? So that's what it is with this tape. A classic 85 bedroom tape. DJ Double K, 15 years old. Yeah, 1985. So now you know my age. Word up. So it's a pleasure, like I say, to present it to you through technology, because it's been sitting on my shelf since 1985. I might have played it like maybe 10 years ago or something, you know. But that's the thing with, you know, classic tapes. You play them as you find them and get them organized and boost them up the technology, get them on a hard drive and all that. So, and you know, if you from me on Facebook, you can see a picture of my mixtape collection. If you don't know what I mean. Or there's a video I did. Maybe you can go to a video on my YouTube channel where you can actually see my mixtape collection. Then you'll know what I'm talking about when I say I'm getting everything organized and whatnot. So, you know, that's what it is, man. So, You get ready to sit back. I want y'all to sit back. Reminisce. It ain't going to be too long. Might be like about 45 minutes or something like that. You know how it takes for a Saturday, 45 minutes or 30 minutes or whatever. So I think this might have been a 90-minute tape or something. So, you know, I'm going to break it down and give narrative descriptions as I always do so you can understand where my head was at when I was, you know, throwing the mix. Word up. So on that note, once again, you about to be in the mix by me, myself, the Ultimate DJ, Double K Live on Storage Room Radio Archive Tuesdays edition. Word up. Bust it out.
You're listening to another Storage Room Radio Master Mix exclusive.
Word up. Bust it out. Bust the mix. 15 years old.
You're listening to another Storage Room Radio Master Mix exclusive.
And if you're down by law, I ain't even got to tell you the name of this record right here. I shouldn't have to tell you the name of none of these records right here because you know they officially came out in 85. Bust it out.
I know a girl named Millie. She acts real silly. Lives in the Bronx, but she comes from Philly. It's no secret that she smokes illy. Acting all wild like a dumb hillbilly. But there is duty. She got a nice booty. Homeboy say she's a real fly cutie. I gotta do my duty to pull that duty. But she stuck like glue to her main man Rudy.
Man, I'm getting ready to have my first deja vu flashback. Bust it out.
Now that is Vicky. I gave her the hickey. But in the other room was a boyfriend, Ricky. Vicky was picky on the presence of Ricky. She told me that I had to make it a quickie. But we was busted. Her mother was disgusted. Hit Vicky in the head with a jar of mustard. Vicky was in anger. She wanted to hang her. But all I wanted to do was bang her.
Listen to the tape hiss. Listen to that authentic tape hiss. That's how you know it's an original tape. Word up. Man.
Now there is Nita, rag by Skeeter, rock by Matt and dog by Peter. But Nita had a ball until she took a fall because she thought that the baby was bothered by them all. I went to Spring Valley. I met a girl named Sally. She took me to the store and she bought me leather ballys. I took her to the rally. I dissed her in the alley. And that is the end of this finale.
Remember, I'm hearing this for the first time in about 10 years. So I don't even know what the next jam is. Word up.
My friend got a brother whose name is Eddie. He also got a sister whose name is Betty. When we chill at the crib, she's always ready to jump in. Sometimes she acts lazy. I had to cut her off for her best friend, Daisy. Daisy is skinny. You might say bony. She plays the field on her boyfriend, Tony. Tony think he's the one and only, but that is the title they use for Sony. Episode
See, this is back in the days we used to let the whole jam play. That's how fresh hip hop was. We had to hear it from beginning to end. My memory is coming back. Now it's coming back. 85.
Strong, and if you think we're weak, I'd say you're wrong. All your other DJs are a bunch of jerks. Smalley, give them an example how a DJ works. The needle wants to slip, it's the needle he'll catch. The A is the letter that you set apart. I wouldn't call his beats music, I would call it art. The R just stands for the way he rocks, which is 24/7 around the clock. The L is for lyrics that I write when put to beat sounds out of sight. The E is for every beat he makes, which sucker DJs persist to take. Don't play with the Y, cause it isn't a game. You ask why did he put the other DJ to shame? After this, there shouldn't be.
Got to close my eyes with it.
Oh,
hold up.
This paragraph here has come to an end.
Hold up.
Molly, can we hear your funky fresh scratching again?
I think I might be going in a little bit on the mix on this. Hold on. I might be going in a little bit on the mix. 15 years old, working it out.
In the game of tag, my name is MC Shan, no need to brag. MC brag about myself all through their rhyme. You can see I got quality, won't waste my time. If I did not mean it, I wouldn't have said it. Gonna give the man behind the wheel some credit.
There it is. I'm working the mix out.
But Molly Marcus stand on his own 2 feet. Since the DJ like him, it's so on demand. Molly, won't you get on
working
the
show it out
where you stand?
Not like the rest. Not like the rest.
There it is.
Can't go on, but I won't insist. How many Fortune DCs have a DJ like this? Time, I always have a plan. DJ Molly Marl and I am MC Shan. Bomb.
Working on my echo scratch. Bring smiles to my face. 15 years old. 85.
It wasn't no thing. You have to have the ace. Ace, Jack, Queen, or a king. One of these. That means you're the best. And people they won't settle for less. Be it king. We can play the place. But we'd rather be DJ and an MC ace.
Get the people dancing.
Dang.
A lot of DJs already tried. Ain't been yet disqualified. Think, beat them, you
listen
must
to that,
be nuts.
Listen to that.
Cut, makes is so precise. When a slice is my
reminiscing.
To put a trait that means right on time. Every jam goes, he always rocks. Spur him, the name, chop. To all your DJs who are always fessing. From man, you can learn a lesson. Heard DD when she took us stand. She's
Marlon. It's one. Hell of a man.
Ready to crack.
Get it off my chest to put my mind at ease. Since when you heard a DJ make cuts like these?
Oh, shit. Now, don't ask me why I got that on it. I don't know why. 1985. Oh, I know why. See, back in the days, you know, we used to DJ 21 and over. We was like 15 DJing 21 and over, so we had to have those 21 and over jams. So I was working it out, practicing for 21 and over. Bust it.
Every little thing you do makes me smile. And if I had my way, baby, I'd tie you up for a while. I'd dig you through the pages one by one. I don't want to get too serious. I just like having fun.
21 and over. See, we was progressive minded DJs back then. Just listen to the selection of songs. This is what we call the 21 and over jam. Which it was. To listen to this. I'll be in my own world. Back then.
You're listening to another Storage Room Radio Master Mix exclusive.
Tapes sound pretty good for over 30 years or whatnot. Gotta give a shout out to my Aunt Nut, Uncle Dude, and all of them on this joint. Cause this was this joint. This was this shit right here. Let joints play all the way to the end. But never do that today. More hip hop coming out. I don't know. Like I said, this is my first time really hearing this in about 10 years. And it's over 30 years old. Remember seeing those 21 and over party people on the floor back in them days, dancing all proper. looking sharp. So we used to say sharp. We used to say fresh. Alright, looks like there's no more hip hop on that segment right there. But I mean, just getting those records for the first time, whether they was hip hop or R&B, and just bringing them back to your bedroom in the projects. It's a sunny day. You done walked all the way to the record store and walked back. You starving because the money you used was the money to buy records, so you didn't have no money to eat. Nothing along the way. We didn't even factor that in back the day that we, like back in them days, that we was gonna be hungry on the journey to get the records. You know what I mean? And all the real DJs know what I'm talking about when it comes to that. We didn't even care about no rack because we was gonna walk. I don't care if it was 15 inches of snow out there. We was gonna walk regardless. You dig what I'm saying? So, you know, to get those records back home and to hear them like that for the first time, it was like the adrenaline rush was incredible, man, because it was like we was almost doing something that was forbidden or something, like to listen to our hip hop or whatever. Like, it was forbidden because it was, you know, they tried to knock it back in them days. You know what I'm saying? And you know, we was like rebellious DJs, or I know I was, so I wasn't going for that. You know what I'm saying? So to play those records, it was like you against the world. You know what I'm saying? That's why it let me know, you know, I knew the importance of the DJ already. But at that time, you really knew the importance because we was like battling bands. That's why I always say bands is not hip hop. You know what I'm saying? Because it was this against them in terms of stage and sound and studio. So that's why the DJ scratches was so powerful on record back then. Records like Marley Marl scratch, Jam Master Jay scratches or whatever. Those was rebellious sounds. It was bigger than DJing. Those was rebellious because you was not supposed to hear that in no party or to the ears even back in those days. So for us to do that and people and to perfect it and to do it well, it was like, man, we claimed our stake in the universe with that universal sound right there. It was to hear a scratch to an old person back then was literally like putting a nail on the record and doing like this. That's what it was to their ear. They didn't care nothing about the creativity of it or what it sounded like. You know what I'm saying? Although they, you know, they was fronting a little bit, but that's what it was to the older people. Like, we messing that record up or whatever. So to hear those sounds and to be rebellious like that at a young age, I'm real, real proud of that. And I'm glad I got this documentation to prove I was dead. Staking my mark, whether you knew me or not, you know it now. So it doesn't even matter. You know, it's just everybody played their part in getting hip hop what it is. Known, unknown, to never being known. You know what I'm saying? That's what preserving your history is all about. See, I was 20 years ahead of my time thinking historical wise back then, because I was recording, doing everything for my purposes of just even wanting to hear the playback of how it would sound. So now with the technology in full throttle, we can, now it comes back into play. I see how the universe, you've seen how the universe works now. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, that was a dope segment right there. You know, like I said, you know, this is like maybe a 90 minute, I think, tape. It's even the time is wore off the tape, so I don't even know. So, you know, I don't know what's on here, man. We just gonna go, I'm gonna play it as it's on here, whatever, straight up or whatever. So we gonna lay back and enjoy like I'm laying back and enjoying right now. And it's bringing back mad memories. First Floor Robinson Court Projects. And matter of fact, if you want to see what my room was like back then, look at the thumbnail. I might make it the thumbnail, this picture. Or you could just go back to one of the shows at Robinson Court, scroll through my YouTube, and you see what my actual bedroom looked like with the equipment I was using to make this tape right here. That was the picture right there. An authentic picture of my bedroom set, DJ room in 1985, right there. That's if, you know, you can check that out. Technique 1200 on the left, straight on the right. A big GLI Jam Master J type mixer, which was like $200-$300 back in the days. And I really didn't want to use that. It was just at a phase where we was upgrading, you know, with the equipment coming off of the SL210B series turntables from back in the 70s and early 80s we was using. to trying to get 212s officially. You dig what I'm saying? So you had to save all, you know, your mom saving up for a lifetime to get that. And with the GLS mixer came about, my pops, he just surprised me with it out of nowhere, because he knew I needed a mixer. I was using, you know, I don't know. I went from the Newmark to the GLI, Realistic Radio Shack. I didn't went backwards from the best because I could never afford the Newmark again. So the Realistic was the next best thing as far as the cheap mixer aspect. So he comes in my room with this big brand new used, well, it was used and was still like $200-something. And it just so happened to be a GLI, the same mixer Jam Master Jay uses. You see him on all them pictures of Run DMC. And that's why you see me on that mixer. That bit, it didn't, I didn't even do too many parties on it. It didn't last long because I couldn't get used to that. I had to get that out of there. And the DJ creativity was going to the next level anyway, which was the following year of battling coming up into play into hip-hop, official DJ battles. So you had to have that small mixer. You know what I'm saying? But it was definitely part of my history and everything. I'm glad I captured it on audio and pictures and visuals and all that, so that's what it was. So let's get back into this and let's see what's going on right here. Bust it out.
You're listening to another Storage Room Radio Master Mix exclusive.
We going, I know where my head was at. This was the ultimate. Bust it out.
You know what they say, honey? Those ain't balloons in the water. Oh, you better watch out. Those boys are out for no good, I tell you.
Matter of fact, I got to bring that back. Bust it out. Man, oh man. This record used to pound through the sound system. That's all I gotta say. Bust it out. Once in a while, take a sniff of the blow.
Over there, they think they're just so well. Yes, they walk through the process with the rotten ass, robbing and stealing. It's nothing less to all the beamers over there. They go to the chest. It's like warm as a fireplace. That's the deal. Cause I could walk through the desert and still be chill. Cause I could dress ordinary and still impress. Cause I'm the newest in the freshest. I am the best. Dress ordinary modes each and every day. Cause on the top of my mic, you know you hear me say,
MJ's over me, getting funky.
I mean, the hip-hop production in 85 is insane. Remember, it was all brand new. It wasn't nothing done before. So how'd they come up with this? You used to go like this with your hand when you heard a scratch.
Cause I'm in the place known for MIC. Every single young lady in the place will agree. There ain't another MC in the place to be that can rock the mic quite like you said I'll be. Here I reign, here I stand. The microphone wizard with the upper hand. The other MCs, they can't understand that Mr. Mac is not your average man. Cause I can hypnotize your body and soul. Make you feel like 24 karat gold. Rock to the beat cause I can't be bold. And all you sucker MCs, I'll put you on hold.
Told you we used to let jams play all the way to the end. Getting all hip hop money's worth out of these records, word up. And if it got,
I'm sure,
and if it got, she was even on the record. That's what I'm saying. Playing it all the way to the end. What the fuck is this?
There is nothing wrong with your radio.
Okay.
Just turn it up.
Oh. Oh. Uh-oh. We wasn't fucking around with real hip-hop back then. We wasn't buying no rapping Duke records back then. Not us. We buying real shit like this. See, this is at a time when the people used to dance the real hip-hop on the dance floor.
Say, turn it up!
That's all we had.
Say, turn it up!
Turn it up!
Say, turn it up!
Turn it up!
We turned it up, but it ain't loud enough. I pose just like a powerful force driven by ancient spirit. Information program them and explode them, blow them out of proportion, create distortion, read the label and proceed with caution, cause I'm on it, and I want it, to put you in a trance, make it dance, like you're in a coma, cause you tried to go home a moment too slow, and now you can't go, what you're hearing, has you staring, dancing, cheering, and comparing, me joint, cause other rappers on the sideline use me as a guideline. Take what I say, rewind and combine what I'm saying with what they wanna say. And I guarantee they're gonna say something petty, cause they're not ready. I am real and they're confetti. My rhymes are legit, their rhymes are counterfeit, their rhymes are miscellaneous, mine's the opposite. If you're standing up, you're rocking, if you're sitting, you're on edge. If I put up a flag, I know you pledge allegiance to me. Kumo D, New York City, number one MC. Yeah. You see, I have a talent I never lost. I might chill for a while, but I could never fall off. And even if I whisper, I'm always louder than any other rapper. And they'll say, how the hell does he do that? Then say, who's that? Rhyme is smoking, Mo D's not joking. Everybody scream, cause the king has spoken. Say, turn it up.
Kumo D, when he first was solo. Turn it up. I remember we was breaking our neck to go get this one. When we first heard Mo D went solo. Cause that he was like one of my favorite MCs. It was just him and Melly Mel to me.
Ladies and gentlemen, just like Yankee Doodle, this rhyme's a dandy. Sweet like sugar, tastes like candy. My mic's like a wife when it comes in handy. Rock the Appalachians on down to the Andes. A chosen rock composer like Mozart. My rhymes are unique as Picasso's art. What I write on the canvas always comes out on. You won't tear it, you'll wear it. East Saint Laurent. You'll be proud of what I wrote, cause what I designed is very genuine. You wanna wear my rhymes. Lots of life, lots of color, but not too loud. When I see your reaction, it makes me proud just to be me. Kumo D, the computer, the undisputed champion MC. Too tough, lot of pop, long rhymes are ferocious. Always sound good, cause I always notice what to say on Saturday and have everybody rocking till Sunday. And when you go to church and clap your hands and pray, I'll have everybody rocking till Monday and make it freak, freak up through the rest of the week. A Friday is my day, or when I reach my peak.
Break down!
Remember saying to myself, man, this is a long record for 1985. But they was all kind of long, to be truthful. But this was long, you know, for late Sugar Hill. I don't know.
Give me a mic, a stage, and a rhythm. A participating crowd, and in return, I'll give them a double dose of what's considered the most.
Break down!
Oh man, oh man. I had like 20 deja vu flashbacks that quick with this record right here. You know what I'm saying? I remember, because you know, it's another banger on the B side of this joint right here. So we used to play both of them. But this particular one right here, you know, like I said, listening to it in my room, it's like a own surreal little hip-hop disco party and whatnot at that time. Because again, I was listening for the lyrical side of it and, you know, just to see how dope it was or where I might want to play it at or whatever, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, this was like a special record, and it was the last of the bangers for Sugar Hill Record. Like, this was it. After this, Sugar Hill was dead officially, and Mo D had kept him alive, you know, by him going solo. So it was a big build up for that record, you know what I'm saying? So that was a dope record to have and to play on this tape, you know what I'm saying, at that time, because again, that was 1985 as well. 1985 was a golden year, you know what I'm saying, because as we all know, the next year, that's when the games got stepped up with Kane and, you know, Karis and all of them, Rakim came coming on the scene. But they was following the people before them, like right on, like at this time. That's why they was able to be so powerful lyrically, because they was analyzing the jams from the 80s, like 84, 85, you know, with Run DMC, Fat Boys, L, Houdini, and all of that. So they had the actual advantage when it came to writing, because they had something to go on already. You know, so that's why you had the next levels of hip hop according to sound. Always remember that. Don't just go by who you think your favorite MC is and all of that and try to throw him into an era he didn't exist in. No, he was just a young dude listening, hoping to get on, studying the greats. I don't care who it is, you know what I'm saying? So you got to look at that accordingly right there. But 84, 85 was so golden, man. I mean, it was Run DMC, LL. I mean, what more is there to be said? You know what I'm saying? So to have all this, them joints on an authentic tape like that, like this right here, it speaks volumes. You know what I'm saying? Because it's part of my history. It was when I was, again, young, 15, and man, I cry right now, but it is what it is, man. So I hope you definitely enjoying that. So I'm gonna hit you off with one more. You know what I'm saying? Again, we're going to see where we at with this, but we get ready to sign off after that. But a definite classic right here, a Double K official bedroom mixtape from 1985. Word up. So let's see. Bust it out.
You're listening to another Storage Room Radio Master Mix exclusive.
Party people, party people, party people, party people.
Okay, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Party people.
Okay. Bring that back. Yeah, okay. What I was doing, I was at the end of all my takes, then I would practice my little cuts and go in with a record or two or whatever, just around the tape off. So this is what I'm doing. So again, you hear early 85 Double K mixes. Listen to that, man. We all definitely know this is 82 when Planet Rock came out. Word up. And you know this is practice, because you can hear I keep bringing it back so many times from the top. You know, it was no format. I was trying to figure it out. And then making my own DST mix up or whatever, you know, a mega mix. Listen to that. You could tell the mixer, the sound of the mixers and electronics was even sounding different back then. It was like cheaper electronics or something, I don't know. Very, very limited with the equipment. You couldn't do but so much. No crabs and no flare scratches and nothing like that. So it wasn't even out yet. So believe it or not, this was what turntablism sounded like back then. as early in his prime as it was, it would have took DJs out. Trust me. Because you couldn't do this on straight on turntables. You had to have 12s or something close to it. Word up. Bust it out. Listen to that. Uh-oh. Trying to catch the beat. I got it. I got it. Early 15-year-old DJ Double K turned Tata Lizzle. What's the mix coming in here? I hear the mix. Man. I want to go back to my bedroom. Hit it with the last, take him out with the last scratches. Long rhythm scratch. So you could tell I was studying the greats like DST Grandmaster Flash. Straight up.
I gotta go now. Y'all take it easy. Bye-bye.
Signing off in the place to be is me, myself, the ultimate DJ Double K, and you've been listening to Storage Room Radio. Word up, live on Ustream, YouTube. Word up, a special edition of Tuesday's archives or whatnot, you know what I'm saying? So, Tuesday's archive edition where, you know, I dig in the crates and throw down all the tapes from back in the days, you know, from my parties and bedroom mixes or whatnot, and that was one of them from 1985. Word. I mean, you know, it's just a mad humbling experience to know the body of work that you built up and the work that you actually put in and to have that documented for the next 1,000 years or whatever. I mean, that blows my mind because, like I always say, when we was doing it, it wasn't no technology. It wasn't no, you know, no camera to capture everything you did. So the little bit of stuff that you did capture, you had to cherish for the rest of your life. You know, unfortunately, a lot of people took it for granted. That's why I don't have nothing from their history that they can present to say, okay, I was doing this, I was there, or I did this, or I did that. It's a shame, you dig what I'm saying? But like I said, I was always progressive-minded thinking when it came to hip-hop, you know what I'm saying? 1,000% I knew I was supposed to do this. I gave up a baseball career in the major leagues because that's where I was headed. I got the trophies and MVP and all that to verify that. So when I shut that down, people were just absolutely shocked by that. But I found my true calling when I heard, you know, Grandmaster Flash. That was it. You know what I'm saying? I even had the coach come up to my house trying to convince me, you doing the wrong thing. You going to the pros and all that. So that's what I'm saying. So to be able to have all that, you know, documented, you know, now so it can be played back to people is an absolute blessing. And that's how you know you put here for a reason. You know what I'm saying? And don't take that for granted. And I believe that's one of the reasons why hip-hop is jacked up today, because a lot of people, including the people who was doing it, took it for granted. And they still do that today. Especially the DJs as well, you know what I'm saying? And the MCs, of course. Y'all took it for granted, man. You know what I'm saying? So to have a piece of history, at least for me, I'm for my piece of history, carving out my niche, so I'm saying I put in work, I contributed to it, is amazing to me. Because I'm always, that's why I say I take the bedroom attitude, everything, even with technology. You see me on this camera, in my mind, I'm still in that project bedroom. I could care less about a camera looking at me, because this is me and my natural element. It's like a lion in the jungle. He don't care about no camera looking at him. He gonna eat. You know what I mean? He gonna kill. He gonna do what he been doing before the cameras and all of that. So that's always been my attitude with this and it being on YouTube and everything. So, you know, I just wanna just big shout outs to everybody who definitely appreciate this, man, because history is important, especially when it comes to hip hop. But we gotta get this back in perspective, and the only way to do that is present actual facts of everything, from especially from DJing perspectives, because the DJ created this hip hop. So, you know, I'm just putting my history and my body of work together. And if you're a DJ, I advise you to do the same, you know, it's different now, but hey, you gotta start somewhere. I was just blessed, and I give thanks that I was able to capture me in my prime in the 80s when hip hop was at its prime. So there it is. Word up. So you know, that's what it is, man. I mean, it's nothing to it. It's nothing. It is what it is. I mean, either you was there doing it or you wasn't. You know what I mean? Cause, you know, I think Grant Flash, he got one of the best quotes I ever heard from a DJ, just in general. You know, I don't know. I think he said something like, you know, he may not be the fastest now. It might be people faster than him on the turntables or something like that, but you can never say you was the first. And that means more than being fast at anything. If you was the first at something, wherever you from, wherever you did, or whatever you do, that speaks volumes. Nothing can ever duplicate that. Nothing can ever be misconstrued, stolen, or anything like that, because you got the, you know, documentation to prove all of that. So I love that quote about, you know, when Flash said that. So that's where my head always be. That's why I be saying, you know, I don't care about no DJ's name. I want to know what you did, and I want to hear it or see it. It's that simple with me. It's cut and dry. You know what I'm saying? Because this is the only way we can get this hip-hop shit back, is to get these frauds up out of here. You know what I'm saying? Because we ain't going to let it go by that easy. You ain't getting no passes. You've been getting too many. You know what I'm saying? So it's, you know, that it is what it is. You know, but as far as me, it's a lot of blood, sweat, and tears. That's all I can say. You know what I'm saying? So I think that's why, you know, God allowed me to make it this far. Because a lot of people ain't make it this far as far as consistency. I mean, my consistency is immaculate. You dig what I'm saying? Whether you know me or just hearing me for the first time right now. You know, so that's the key to everything, consistency. You know what I'm saying? And you as a DJ, you always supposed to go up anyway. You never supposed to go down or be stagnated where you was at. That's like me sounding like I was in 85. Imagine me mixing like that now, like I'm sounding like I'm still in 85. That's what I mean. That's the difference. You supposed to go up. You know what I'm saying? Keep your original style in DNA, but you gotta go up and upgrade. You don't want to sound like you sounded then. You just incorporate it in, but you add it up. That's always been my attitude. That's why I can honestly say I'm a complete original. I don't watch nobody. I never study nobody but the greats. You dig what I'm saying? So it was never a thing of fight with me, because I was always like, I'm going to do something totally different. You dig what I'm saying? And that's what it was. So that's what it is, man. That's what we need to get back to. And that's what, like, shows like this, I'm, you know, far as I'm concerned, is all about. So you can have a reference point. You can have a starting point. You can go and build your block from that starting point, wherever you're from, whatever city or whatever you do, rap, DJ, and all of that. You got to have a starting point. Or you just going to stay right where you are, and you won't even know it. You think you're doing something nice, like great, and you really 20 years behind without even knowing it, because you ain't do your research or history or homework. So I believe that's what, why, you know, God created cameras and even technology, so you can have a reference point. Imagine life without cameras and all of that, and tapes and all of that back in them days. You know what I'm saying? Ooh, man. Hip-hop, imagine hip-hop getting get captured on tape. Like, imagine flashing them back in the days when they was doing the parties before records and all that in the parks. Imagine the tape. What? Imagine none of that on tape. Now you know what I'm talking about. You know how much confusion we would be in right now. And people be like, I was the first DJ to do this. I was the first rapper to do that. See, there is, with that documentation, you better not open your mouth. You can't open your mouth. And that's what I'm saying. That's what we need to get back to. You know, so big shouts to all the real DJs, though. I love all of y'all, man. I appreciate y'all and everything. And I was never the jealous type, because I knew I was one of the greats, whether you know me or not. You know what I'm saying? And that's not ego. That is actual facts that has been proven. And you could check my catalog and body of work through video and audio documentation such as today. So we need to get back to that. That's all I'm trying to say, man. So I enjoy listening to other people's history. If you put something out that was dope from you back in the day, I'm going to give you props on that shit. I like that shit. You know. So that's what it is today, man. Archive Tuesdays live on Storage Room Radio. Nothing exclusive. This is not even a real, real official show. It's just like I say, when I dig in my tapes, dig in my files, and I come across the classics one at a time. Because I got to do it one at a time. Like I say, you can check my video archives of my tape collection out on this. Scroll through my videos on YouTube, the archives, and see what you see I'm talking about my tapes. Or maybe I ain't uploaded yet. I'll upload it. Put it like that. I got it in my I'll upload it, you know. So that's what it is, man. I'm going to keep this going until I get down to my last tape. It might take at least 3-4 years. I'm going to tell you that right now. God willing, you know what I'm saying? Because that's how much work it is, because we talking 60 and 90 minute tapes. So I gotta listen to it, not listen, but scan it just to see what it is, because some shits is labeled and ain't. You know how I was with them tapes. You know what I'm saying? So, or even if it's even still playable, you dig what I'm saying? I gotta go through all that, man. It's like a research science project or some shit. I'm willing to do it. I'm just about putting in work and building and preserving my history. And I advise y'all to do the same. Word up. So yeah, on that note, and so like I said, I think now what I'm gonna do, I just realized I got a picture of me in my room the day I was doing this tape. I forgot all about that. I got like 3 pictures from that 85. And I was get ready. I was on the wheels, and I think my mom came in and caught me on a mix. You know what I'm saying? And I thank God for that. And what I'm going to do is I think I'm going to make that one a thumbnail. Either that or the actual picture of the DJ equipment itself. But I think I already got that up. So if you can scroll through, and if you see a bedroom with Run DMC poster hanging over top of the turntables, that's my bedroom. That's when I made that mix. And this was that's the equipment I was using. But I want to put a picture of me standing on the turntable with my Kango on. You can see a little bit of the GLI mixer in the middle. So that's me actually doing this tape. There it is. Hey, man. When you think of that word archives, my face should be the poster child. I mean, I know you got your DJ heroes and all that other shit out there, and that's cool. But, you know, they ain't providing history the way I want to see it. I mean, I don't know. All they working with is the name and all that shit, man. I need to see something. I don't care about your name. And that's no disrespect. I love all the DJs, you know, the real ones. But if you got history and you ain't presenting it, man, then you don't even go that route with it. Just stay right where you at with it and just keep playing this shit that you play and all of that. Because this shit is real frustrating with this shit. Because like I said, I'm always going to blame the DJs for the state of hip-hop and all this shit. Because the blaming the rapper speaks for itself. I'm blaming the programmers of this shit. That was us. And I'll take part of the blame because in the 90s, I took a back seat and I took a solemn oath. I said, I ain't playing none of this 90s bullshit except the Deep Underground, which is what you hear me playing. I had the bullshit, but I never played it. You know, maybe for party purposes, but that was few and far between by choice. I sat it out intentionally and went to the next level. So all the other DJs didn't. They grabbed that shit and they put it out there. So it's almost the equivalent of how, you know how they say, you know, well, we don't have guns. Guns is put in the community by whomever powers to be. Well, same thing with music. We the programmers, we was the powers to be. We put that shit out there. So I'm blaming us. That's how real I am. I don't care. You can have your opinion, but the facts is what it is. You can't dispute the facts. You dig what I'm saying? And I know everybody DJ might hear this, so y'all might try to take my words and put it on your show like break a concept down. But this is how I always been thinking. That's why I say I took a back seat. So that's why a lot of that music that was detrimental in the 90s, you haven't heard me really play that on these shows yet, if you've been following me. You haven't heard me play none of that shit from the 90s that was detrimental. I don't have to name it. You already know what it was. You know what I'm saying? And that's I'm still taking a solemn oath. I'm not programming that shit. I didn't like it then. I don't like it now. If I play it, it'll be strictly for a party purpose scenario. That's it. So I said we supposed to use this technology to bring forth the light of the shit that didn't get to just do anyway. That's how I'm utilizing the technology on my end. I'm not trying to regurgitate and reprogram the same old garbage and shit that killed off a whole 90s generation. Why would I do that? Why would I reprogram garbage when it was already programmed? It's had its day. It's had its time. Now let's bury that shit and keep it buried this time so the next generation on hip-hop can't go through that. For the next generation of real DJing, I should say. So that's just my take on it, man. Like I said, I'm about to do some shit called Real DJ Talk. And DJs, don't bite my shit, because I know y'all out there, y'all looking for ideas and shit. And I'm on this internet with my third eye. You just don't know it. And I ain't got nothing to lose when it comes to fucking. You fuck with me, man. And I'm not no tough guy. I'm just a real nigga DJ. That's it. So I'm just saying, I got to speak it for what it is. I can't sugarcoat nothing. I can't, you know, act like it was this when it wasn't. I can't do that. I ain't built like that. I'm cut from an entirely different thread. Like I say, fuck a cloth, a thread. You know what I'm saying? And that's just what it is with me, man. And I'm sorry if I'm offended, but I got love for you. But we just got to set this shit straight with the truth and facts. I'm not here to be no fucking friends. I'm here to be the truth. You know what I'm saying? Straight up. So if you with me, then you gonna understand that, and we gonna rock out together, cause I'm all about loyalty. Word. And lastly, you gotta remember who we doing it for, the ancestors, man. Don't upset the ancestors on some real shit. If you got knowledge yourself, you'll know what I'm talking about. They didn't, you know, give us this shit to fucking disrespect and hand over and get disrespected again. It don't work like that, on at least not on my watch. So that's what it is, man. I'm gonna let you know when I start that real DJ talk shit. So normally the shit you hear me talk at the end like this, now I'm gonna make a show of it. Everybody else on you, I played the back. I watch all the DJs talk and get their opinions on shit. and non-factual shit and then break down their opinion. And that's cool, that's your opinion, but it ain't fact. It's not facts. So I feel now it's time for me to step up and voice my opinion based on facts. Because I'm going to present it just like I present it today and every other day. You know what I'm saying? So that's the difference between us over here, man. We about facts. It ain't where the fuck you from and all that shit no more. It's about real. Been recognized real. Not real recognized real. Been recognized real. So if you real, you going to know what it real. You know real when you see it. It's like, what, that ain't hard. It's like, oh, that's real shit right there. Based up with facts. You know what I'm saying? That's all I'm about. Word. So that's it for the day, man. I should be back in another. I don't know. I might space these out every 3 weeks, maybe month, every month or whatever. I'll pop off an archive, you know, just so you'll know and take my stake on, you know, the internet, YouTube, whatever, to the world all over that appreciate it and appreciate history and a student of history, because that's what I am. I'm a student of history. And it don't have to necessarily be DJ and music or hip-hop related, just history in general. If it's truth, I want to know about it. I want to get into it. You know what I'm saying? So that's what it is. So, yeah, we're going to sign it on off, man. And once again, as always, big shouts to all our YouTube subscribers, man. We inching on 7,000. I can't show no more appreciation than I do, man, because my passion speaks for itself. My work ethic, my body work, my content. If you're not convinced about my realness today, and it's not ego or bragging, always make that distinction with me. I'm a humble dude, and the reason I can be that humble, because I can give you props. Now, the problem is when you don't give me props, then it becomes like, okay, I gotta tell you what I'm about, what I'm made of. My DNA is built up through actual facts, and that's all it is. It's not no tough talk, because I love you regardless, you know. If you real, because you can't be walking around loving everybody today. No homo. But, like I said, that's all it is over here, man. So, like I said, I'm going to pop it off maybe once every month, and we're going to keep this moving with the archives, and I hope you enjoy it. And that's what it is, man. Big shouts to all our YouTube subscribers all over in India, Germany, Alaska, Africa, Switzerland, London, Kenya, China, you know who you are, man. Egypt, everybody inbox me. Enjoy the shows and the versatility and the difference. Word up. I appreciate y'all, man. I'm doing it for y'all. And again, it's free. But if you feel in your heart to donate to Storage Room Radio, man, you can donate through my YouTube account. My PayPal account, which is srpmangmt@yahoo.com. That's srpmangmt@yahoo.com. Because, see, it's not about... When you talking about donate, man, you should do it for the right reasons according to the person's passion, man, and skill set and what he's trying to do and accomplish. Not about the content necessarily, although that's a big part of it. But when it comes to me, just check out and pay attention to my passion and then the skill set. You know, because that's all in one right there. And if you feel in your heart that you like this dude putting in work, he's doing it for the right reasons, he's trying to get the shit back the way it's supposed to be, it's a nearly impossible mission, but he's going to go through the hell of it anyway, then so be it, man. You know, so that's all I can say on that. I'm going to keep putting it out there regardless, but we are human. You got to be human with it too. Because that's the only thing that's so bad about the internet. It's a gift and a curse, because it's so much content on here that it has brainwashed people to think, you know, everything is supposed to be free. Everything ain't supposed to be free, and you know that. It ain't supposed to be high and all the astronomical dollars, but it's supposed to be have a value amount to it, and you know that. Especially when you get some original good content like this, where you ain't gonna find nowhere else. You're not gonna find your favorite DJs, whoever name they is. You're not gonna find them playing no shit like I play. It's just that simple. You know, I've researched it even before I came out. And you can still keep listening and they're not going to play no shit like this. And it ain't ego. It's facts. I would love to hear other DJs play the same real shit. Not the same, but the real shit I play. So we get all one accord and we can take shit back accordingly. Or make our strides, you know. So that's all it is, man. So fill it in your heart. Go ahead and donate to Storage Room Radio, man. So that's all I can say on that. you know, it ain't about bagging like that. It's just about so we can keep this moving. I would like to get back to doing 2, maybe 3 hour shows like I originally started, because I got a whole nother stash of music I ain't even present yet, especially as far as 90s. I'm just sitting on it because I got to feel, it got to be appreciation now with it. We got over 250 shows popping off. Views pretty good, you know, humble brother. So I feel I gotta get something, you know, and just for the right reasons though. So big shouts to once again all our YouTube subscribers worldwide. If you haven't subscribed, go ahead and click that subscribe button and check out the video archives. You won't be disappointed. You'll definitely find at least one show or two you can get into, and you'll be should be hooked from there, you know. And that's what it is, man. So on that note, once again, he was in the mix by me, myself, the ultimate DJ Double K, and you've been listening to Storage Room Radio International, The Realness, live on YouTube, Ustream, a special archive, Tuesday's archive edition. And I'm out.
You're listening to another Storage Room Radio Master Mix exclusive.
I love this record.
You're listening to another Storage Room Radio Master Mix exclusive.